Despite a court ruling upholding the 1.7 billion shilling service award to the four parliamentary commissioners, Theodore Sechikubo, the MP for Lemayaga County, insists that Parliament should allow the debate on the motion. During yesterday's plenary sitting, chaired by Deputy Speaker Thomas Tayebwa, Sechikubo expressed his concern about how the censor motion has been handled, yet he has followed the required procedures. He said they have raised the required 176 signatures, however, Parliament has denied him a chance to table the motion for debate. Sechikubo added that he obtained evidence that Deputy Speaker Tayebwa was among the beneficiaries of the said 1.7 billion shillings and asked him to redeem his reputation.
Right, Honorable Speaker, a motion supported by 186 signatures formed part of Parliament. Right, Honorable Speaker, the moment it gotten into the processes of Parliament, it had to be processed to its logical conclusion. But finally, what we are getting now, you are part of that meeting. And there are changes. Every day we delay, new inputs are being made, corrections to the minutes are being made, and we are left at a loss. So, right, Honorable Speaker, why are you doing this injustice to this House?
In response, Deputy Speaker Thomas Tayebwa said the matter was ruled over in the courts of law and that Speaker Anita Mong was already guided on the matter. He added that he would consult high authorities before ruling on the matter.
Noted that. Kindly allow me to consult. Okay? Because even me as a presiding officer, I have taken copy people I consult. Thank you.
On August 12th, Justice Douglas Karikona of the Civil Division of the High Court ruled that the 1.7 billion shillings which the four commissioners shared as a one-off service award in May 2022 was legal. At least eight people died, including three children, after a seven-story building collapsed in Sierra Leone's capital on Monday. Authorities said with more trapped under the rubble. The building in Eastern Freetown, thought to be used for both residential and commercial purposes, collapsed between 11 a.m. and 12 p.m. GMT. The National Disaster Management Agency, NDMA, said in a statement, a large-scale rescue operation involving two cranes was underway yesterday afternoon. Large crowds gathered around the remains of the structure with concrete slabs piled high next to the corrugated metal roofs of neighboring buildings. Sierra Leone is one of the world's poorest countries and buildings are often poorly constructed using substandard materials. I'm gonna go to the hospital.